Hello. And welcome back to some more Terraria. I really hate that. It's inconsistent about whether it plays the music or not. So I have an idea of what I want to do today. I want to do the Abyss, at the very least, by the end of the stream. And I'd like to finish building the ocean base to our right. Maybe even prepare an arena for the Skeletron fight later on. Later down the line. But I do want to do all the bosses that are supposed to be done before it. Before we do the Skeletron fight. While it's doing that loading, I'm going to double check something. Glowing mushroom biome. I forgot to check this. Low death of zero. Okay. So, please. Alright. So, one of the things we need to do is we need to find a glowing mushroom biome from underneath. And we also need to build some homes. I'll tell you what, let's where's my wood? It's in here. I put it in here last time. Alright. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to build some homes. I think we'll do a little bit of advanced prep. And make the number of homes. So we have 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Seven. The reason why I'm building the homes and why I'm planning on searching for the glowing mushroom biome first is because I want to get a lot of dirt blocks specifically to continue working on our sky bridge so we have a bit of a means of fast travel between the different locations like the two different oceans and jungle and the skull dungeon. There's a lot of stuff I want to be able to make, but can't. Oh wait, no, maybe that's supposed to be over one. Let's find out.
Oh, that's too small. This is wrong. This isn't what I wanted. Next will be hammers. So I was wanting to stream Phantom Abyss, the first person roguelike temple crawling thing. But for some reason it's telling me I need to be logged into Steam, even though I'm literally launching it from Steam. I mean, I had other errors before that even, so it's being a little buggy. I wasn't able to launch it for a second time today, so that's probably not gonna happen. For a while at least. Which kinda sucks, but I mean, oh well. What can you do, right? What can you do? What do you do with the PA in English? As the song goes. And so it goes, and so it goes. But anyway, so that's probably not gonna happen for a while. I'm trying again. I have a fix I can try, but it looked like something that was gonna take a long while, and I wanted to stream, so. I'm playing Terraria. Which I love. But I was actually wanting to play it earlier. Which means I might need to do another stream after this. Something else, because I'm trying an alternating thing. Or I do a different game. Every other stream. As opposed to the same one back to back. Just because I think that would be better for me to get rid of. Having multiple playthroughs. Might do some Phoenix Wright tonight, actually. This would probably be a good night to do that, if that's the case. Especially since tomorrow night's not gonna work.
crafts walls. We're gonna need so many of these, it doesn't matter if I make excess. Housing is not all too exciting. I apologize. And honestly, probably the digging for the flowing mushroom forest won't be all that exciting either. That's definitely something we will actually need to farm. No, God. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Did I make nine? Two, three, four, five, six. I did. Oopsie. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. I need to get more wood. Those take up a knot, a lot.
blood moon. That creates a little excitement. I had to get rid of this. And let's just confirm that all these are suitable. Great. I'm going to move him over to where the beach house will be. But for now, let's go over here. Oh yeah, there's also the cultists we want to kill. What was that? Dream Stride Essence. And grass. Hat so I can catch the hands. Real hits inflict shadow flame. Okay. It's a yo-yo. Yeah. Well, I guess now we can look at the cultists' loot. Sacrificial dagger. Sometimes I hit tagged enemies may deal extra strikes of damage. Okay. Interesting. Anyway. I think we will go out. This way. And hopefully we'll get a lot of dirt and stone in the process. Although I guess we don't really need stone, it's just the dirt I want. Why do they not go after the enemy slimes? little bit. Further to the left. I don't think I'll find it here. That's the case. Ice skate part of the upgrade.
Right.
That actually kind of sucks. Reversing this. Sanguine Ward. Killing enemies inside your blood aura heals some life. Well, that's not too bad. And what's that from? Spirits? Yeah. Thank you. mine. Cryolite. Something's falling from the sky. Okay, I'll bite. What is it? Spirit mod. Sounds like it came from above. We're to the right of it, so could be from the right of our base as opposed to right there, right there. Let's go check though. Actually, could potentially be a bridge too. Honestly, I need to find a spot and just dig straight down. Let's go from... here. That little dent in the minecart path. Gonna dig straight down. Ugh. Water. Hate water. Ugh. Good gourd. We should be below the zero height now. So hopefully we'll encounter a mushroom fire. Excuse me, sorry. I really want to use dirt for the sky bridge, not stone, so I can use it for more tree planting. Straight down. No detours. Yeah. Ugh. Thankfully, we're almost there. Well, I say almost there, I have no idea where the mushroom biome might be. But we're almost to the 5,000 dirt. We're not actually almost there, never mind. I'm just stupid, ignore me. Diamond! Diamond. Aerolite. Come on. You've got to be kidding me. Nice that the wasp actually made an effort to target enemies. Sound was really bad. Oh, you.
Ay, ay, ay.
So, where are we at? Not bad. It could be worse, for sure. Diamond gems. Ooh, what's. Oh, I think I know what that is. We will go over here to get the diamonds real quick. I'm glad that shot monster is dead. Really eased my spirit. Air light. Once more. Still no sign of the mushroom biome I'm looking for. I could probably beat Viscount. Diggy diggy hole. Ah! This is getting to be a bit much. Wow. Not great. Starting to notice a bit of a trend here. Well, didn't get half as much as I wanted. But it'll have to do. It'll have to do. Go off for now. I still have these on me. But we forgot to put them up. At least twice now. One moment. Sorry about that. Just a roommate interrupting again. And I told him not to. God. I've been working on the sky bridge with my wormy scarf, my two locuses and my mask, and my ancient Egyptian styled robe. Why I'm wearing that still, I do not know. They delay going after it for so long. even halfway there. 1,400. We placed about 400 blocks already. Was it 1,400 or was it 1,500? I can't remember. But like, imagine getting this actually built. This is really something I should be doing off stream, actually. Yeah, forget it. Let's go. Let's just run to the freaking beach. I chopped down a regular tree on the way there to get some acorns because I was stupid and didn't get any. If I had the double jump, that wouldn't have been an issue. Lantern attack things as well. An ascension orb, huh? As uncommon as those are, I'm not gonna. This looks like a weird thing. Alright, jungle, how much further are we? Oh, god. It's a little bit too big in the world. Which wouldn't be an issue if the freaking...
Terra custom mod worked. Because then this would be way more varied with the unique biomes that actually supposed to exist in the mods. Now I could have just gone and fought a queen bee. Could still do that, I guess. Still in a jungle. So that's still an option. Am I prepared to fight the queen bee? I mean, I guess technically I am, thanks to these, but I don't know. It still feels kind of cheap. Relying on them when they do 94 rapid damage. I mean, those things alone are gonna be carrying me through the wall of flesh. What was that? Fair bit of mud. Stop running from me. He's running. Charge strikes release the field toxins. Should be strong knockback. And that's what? A melee weapon. I don't care about it then. Alright, let's go. Why do you not. Why do you sometimes not run on it? I'm not pressing down. I can't remember. I think there's another forest between me and the ocean. Yeah. There's at least this forest. We're so close. We're so close. We're almost there. Oh, wow. Yeah.
flatten out some land for the trees to grow. Get enough palm wood to make much, so we'll make a. What we'll do is we'll make a workbench. Not that one. Level up. Okay, great. Can you please move? Kind of in the way of me making things. Palm wood workbench. Palm wood platform. And then level 11, level 8. Alright. No underwater boss lady. Again. Okay. I mean, that's fine, I suppose. I was kind of hoping she'd be here, so I could try to kill her. I want to get the abyss done before I quit tonight. I might stop early and take a nap so that I can do Phoenix. Because I want to stream this tomorrow too. Leaf. Apple. I'll put that there.
it. Let me get this. For until we get there. Oh, that's so much nicer. Although if I was traveling through space, then this would be way quicker. Well, it'd be sort of quicker, I guess. Potentially quicker. But well, because of the Tinkerer, I don't really need the Sushi mod. Do I? I guess it's like confession, a part of this playthrough is me looking for mods that I want to use when I play Journey's End when it finally has a working mod loader. Though I'm definitely waiting for Terra Custom. Custom as like an option for mixing biomes with Corruption and Crimson. Because my favorite thing to do with the Terra Custom, the main reason why I want to use it so much, is because you can make it where on one side of the world Corruption spawns and on the other Crimson spawns, so that you have access to both worlds and all the bosses that are unique to them. And I'd like to have like the option to make it where there's at least one snowy Corruption, there's at least one maybe half snowy, half desert Corruption, one mushroom biome Corruption, one ocean Corruption, and everything Corruption, like Corruption, every combo Corruption has, Crimson has as well. Corrupt forest, corrupt briar, if that's at all possible. That sort of thing, is that all possible? I know there's like a cryogenic world spawn for either Calamity or Thorium, I think it was. Anyways, I think it's Thorium. If it is for either of those two, it's probably Thorium. That was in large part why I wanted to try and use it for this one. And also have the option to have two dungeons and them both be pretty large. Would have been nice. But I can't do that because Terra Custom is 32-bit and can't handle processing the first set of mods. Like, one mod all on its own. It's super. Because it would be able to if it was 64-bit. And they were originally going to make a 64-bit version before Journey's End came out. And then they were like, I'm going to wait until Team Mod Loaders updated for that. Which is a shame. Or at least I remember them mentioning the possibility. They might not have said that they were going to actually do it. I don't know. Oh well. It doesn't really matter. Because it doesn't exist for 64-bit Team Mod Loader, Terra Custom doesn't exist. Nor does the Team Mod Loader for Journey's End exist yet. At least. Yes, they don't give any updates, I noticed. Hmm. so Corrupt Desert's the one. Corrupt Desert's the one with a cool thing. This one's the regular thing that I'm used to hearing all the time. One thing I know I want to do before Wall of Flesh is I want to make a bunch of demon altars, because I want to be able to hit like a whole bunch of them, destroy them with the Wall of Flesh hammer reward. Spawn as much ore as possible. I also want to do as much fishing as possible with the crate potion to get as much get as many crates as possible so that I can just open them for free ore. Oh my god. For free ore. Hard mode ore, that is. I think maybe 500 crates will do the trick. Might even get the fish equipment. The Saw Shark Redemption. Pickaxe Shark, maybe. Not entirely sure about that, actually. But I love that people make so many creative ideas for, like, challenges. Like a fishing build. Which is kind of funny, but it's possible because the game literally makes it an option. And it's also a little overpowered. It's a little busted. Really. So I'm thinking I might need to dig my way. Through the sands, down this way if I can. But I think there is a part that is like so difficult to break through that you quite literally cannot do it with I'm getting some severe lag, as you can tell. It's just a material. I can't build a house with it. Okay. Well, I probably just won't build a house here then. The game is acting like it's gonna crash. Not a fan of that. Okay. Let's increase the next number of minions too. to the abyss before I die. Stop. Stop landing there and just actually fall. There it is. We're here. Oh, and it only took forever. Come on, summons. Do something. Don't just stand there looking at it like two idiots. Alright. Yeah, can't break it. Didn't think so. What I need to do is see if I can find a cave to the right. No, not really. Oh, there's my cave. I don't have a shadow key. Okay. Let's see if that does anything. No, it does not. Seems this abyss was a little poorly generated. Well, unless I go through there, maybe. Let's see if we can't find a way to make a tunnel to a safe locale. Lovely. So they thought that through. Cheeky bastards. These blocks all contain water. Or every other block seems to. Eventually this water will get so high that I need to go up more. Maybe it's rare enough that I don't need to. But in order to get a shadow key, I need
I need to go into the dungeon. Alright, so Abyss is close to the dungeon. I forgot all about that. Good to know. Good to reconfirm. Ah. Oh, goody. More water. Still burning me. Supposed to be on the surface, isn't it? Aquatic urchin. But okay, okay, we've got a safe place to dig down to now. Lagging a bit. Question is, oh, we're still under the Sulfurous Sea. Yeah. That jellyfish is dying. It's gonna die any second now. Well, especially because of that. Yeah, the game doesn't like me being here. I like how biomes in this game change, not based on location, but not the location of the place rather, but on the location of the player. A little further right. And who knows, maybe we'll find that freaking mushroom biome we've been looking for. Yeah, we got really bad luck on the way this spawned. I think we can literally only get that one chest. That sucks. Might create a small world just to actually get some loot from the Abyss. But we'll do that post-Skeletron, I guess. Skeletron. Where is... Bastard. Way over there. Okay. I might try to see if Terra Custom can handle a small world. If you can, I might make several of those. Just for, like, super explorations before we go into hard mode. Or maybe I'll just do the fishing there. Right here's good. Alright, let's return home.
Still no sign of the mushroom biome. So what am I going to do? That's just too big. I think that extra large world mod was a bad decision. Even though, I mean, it's not that bad. But God, Terra Custom not working with it for some for being 32-bit, which is a pretty stupid reason in my opinion. Really. Sucks. That only goes that far. God. Okay, well, we're gonna spend the rest of this stream let's go to this cave. We're gonna spend the rest of the stream trying to find what is this? Flight, super fast running, and extra mobility on ice. Has the ability to walk on water and lava. Grants immunity to fire blocks. 7 seconds of immunity to lava. Increased jump height and negates fall damage. 8% increased move speed. Nice antisocial stats will be gained. Wowie. Breaking the grass behind me. Oh, I guess it was the Eater of Worlds corruption thingy. Because it does that. Right. That's a good sign. The decree. Frigid ooze. Don't know where to find that. I have an idea of where to find it, but I don't know if it's a monster drop or if it's an evil line. I have no interest in checking. I forgot I was gonna get rid of that mod. Shadows of Abaddon seems like a terrible mod, honestly. I still haven't quite decided. Otherwise I would have done it, I guess. Yeah, I think I will. I mean, I don't think we've gotten any of the NPCs for it yet. Plus, it just seems like a waste. I wonder if that'll corrupt the save world, though. Well, at the very least, we'll avoid the bosses from it. Because, and the NPCs if we can. Okay, it's just the desert in general that has the buff. I don't know why I keep forgetting that. I've had to have forgotten it like 8 times by now. Right? Okay, we're almost there. Gold keys in the dungeons from slimes to open the gold chests that might have the shadow keys that we need for both the chests in hell and the chests in the abyss. The abyss is probably going to be better. Especially since what we get from hell is probably going to be no better than what we already have. Thank you.
need to drink or eat. Desperately need more dirt too. I haven't seen one of you in a while. I really? That was a counterweight after hitting an enemy with the yo-yo. Okay. These leveling mods are definitely too. I'm not opposed to ending this run through short and doing a different one with different mods. Or slightly different mods at least, but. Or even a smaller world, but I don't know. Well, we went to the Abyss like I wanted to, even though we didn't get to explore it like I wanted to. And we learned that the spawn of the Abyss is really messed up. Like, it's bad. Outright awful. That was some messed up shit. We quite literally cannot progress past the first chest. Which is not normal. To my knowledge, anyways. Can you go? Diamond. Okay, well, I guess I'm gonna have to play this off stream at some point to build that bridge I wanted to build, and I'll probably try making that a small world, small custom world. Right after I end the stream. But I need to find a mushroom biome. I'll save the finding a mushroom biome, I think, for later. If it happens while off stream, then it happens, but if it doesn't, then it can be a fun little expedition. I suppose. I don't know, I'm not quite sure about that. I literally don't need this anymore. It's just not all useful. This still hasn't given us any minions. We're at level 6 of 15 when the maximum proficiency is 12,500 and we're only at 2,200. It's a little weird. But thank you for joining me, ladies and gentlemen, whether it was here or now, earlier or later, I appreciate it all the same. I hope you have a lovely day, a lovely night, whatever it may be. And goodbye. Oh, hold on, actually. I guess I should say what I'm planning to do next time we stream this. Which might be a while, like Stardew Valley and Rest of Tyr. I do want to go back to them at some point. I just don't know when. Probably a few months, honestly. Next time, we will have a lot more time to spend on it. So, next time, we will try to fight as many bosses as possible. That's about all I can say, really. Well, until then. Bye-bye.